Okay, students, now we'll start with part 3. Okay, the part 3. We had stopped at the United Nations rules. The second last paragraph there now, page 33. Then the mother concluded. Concluded means she ended her talk, her information with Lantoy. My dear daughter, we can affirm along with the United Nations that men and women are equal. We can affirm means we can also have the support of the United Nations that men and women are equals. Lantoy understands what her mother means, and Lantoy here now understands what her mother means and what the topic of symposium means. Topic of symposium, as you know, symposium like a debate, a discussion, yes, where you have to prove your point. Thus, confident of success. Now, she is confident that she will be successful in this discussion. The next day, after thanking her mother, the girl of 12, Lantoy was a girl of 12 years, happily rushes out of her room, of the room, in the bright morning sun. Now, students, see, this also symbolizes something, that she goes into the bright morning sun, means showing positivity, showing something positive, a positive feeling. Yes, she does not feel dull. She has, first of all, her family is such a loving family. Her father, such an understanding person. Her mother, not only caring for the family and house also, was a journalist plus a woman activist, and her father a lawyer, and also supporting the mother in her activities. Means what a great family. Very rarely we find. Sometimes the woman want to do something, but no, the men of the house wants to pull them back. No, no doing. What will people say? Yes, log kya kahenge? They don't want their wives to work. They don't want their wives to take some leadership skills. Okay, but many men support the women. Yes, they support their daughters to pursue studies. Come on. To take up to some profession. Yes, that is the support that women need. But many a times the woman has lot of potential, lot of abilities, lot of talents, but she does not get the support. And here Lantoy finds that this particular bright morning sun shows, oh, what a positive house and what a positive feeling she has about her house and about the background of her house. The blue sky meets the range of the eastern mountains. Oh, what a nice scenery and what a nice positive feeling. The blue sky means the bright clear sky meets the range of the eastern mountains. The small girl is always fascinated by the small trail. Yes. Now, this shows that the girl staying in this particular far away place, yes, she is fascinated by the small road that which winds up the distant purple mountain. Yes, means it goes up the distant purple mountain, means it is rising up. So, students, see the positivity in this. Whether a road is small, also it's reaching the top. That shows there is another meaning here. However small opportunities you get, you should try to make the most of it. Yes, because I told you all before also, life is not a bed of roses. Yes, there are lot of difficulties, lot of problems, but the person who faces these difficulties, who faces these problems, can reach, even if the road is narrow, they can reach to the top. Yes, they can achieve greatness. Did you all understand this lesson, students? Yes. Now we'll go to the activities. Yes, the activities. First, of course, see the warming up here. You all can do it on your own. Yes, self-study. new syllabus. So self-study means study the pictures below and note down the differences. I think I had explained to you all what differences, boy going to school, girl carrying water. Then again in the second part we see the boy and girl both going to school, that shows equality. In the second part, again inequality, one woman teaching, another woman carrying water. Okay, so like that, there are not everywhere the equality is not there. Now going to the English workshop on page 34. Students, I will just keep your pencils hand in your hand so that you can write what I say. And over that, what is not there in the syllabus, you all can just strike it off. Okay. Going to activity 1A. Find from the lesson words, phrases that mean the following. Colors. Colors means hues. H-U-E-S. Now this word is there in the textbook. A person who writes for newspapers or magazines. Journalist. Journalist. See the spellings in the text. Make a difference between. Discriminate. Make a difference between. Discriminate. D-I-S-C-R-I-M-I-N-A-T-E. Cry over. Laments. Cry over laments. Explain in detail, throw light upon. Explain in detail, throw light upon. Abilities and qualities, abilities and qualities, potential. Abilities and qualities, potential. Same availability, equal access. Same availability, equal access. A person who brings about social political change, activist. A-C-T-I-V-I-S-T. Now, pick out 5 compound words from the lesson. Now, what are compound words? Compound words are words that when you hold them together, they make a different meaning. And you hold them apart, yes, they will make 2 different meanings. Okay? Now, here you can, first word, middle-aged, middle-aged. Second word, reading room, reading room. Next word, motherhood, motherhood. Next word, courtyard, C-O-U-R-T-Y-A-R-D. Next word, social worker, social worker. Okay, now activity 2 is for self-study where you have to write the answers. Okay, students, do it on your own. Now, who said to whom and when? The world is full of inequalities. Now, students, just strike out the when. Only you all will have to who said to whom, not when and why. The world is full of inequalities, mother to Lanthor. I want to do something interesting. Lanthor to mother. It is against the will of God. Mother Lanthor. Mother to Lanthor. Our home is full of love. Lanthor to mother. We can affirm along with United Nations that men and women are equal. Mother to Lanthor. Now students, see, going to this particular activity 4, we will be doing it separately in grammar, but here I will just give you all an explanation, like about prepositions. I have taught you all in the grammar class the parts of speech, prepositions and pronouns. Yes, prepositions of course show the position. Here we are going to talk about the pronouns which are used instead of nouns. Okay, now in pronouns also, as I told you all, there are first person pronoun, second person pronoun, third person. But there are also in that also there are different pronouns, that is demonstrative pronoun, personal pronoun, relative pronoun and interrogative pronoun. Now as we go to the first one, yes, like for example, like if I'll speak, I, me, my, your. This is my brother, Yes? Or these are called personal pronouns. My, I, you, your, personal. It's used for your person. Demonstrative pronoun, which points out to something. This is that. Those are my books. Okay? They are demonstrating. Demonstrating means pointing out. Then there are relative pronouns. Yes? The girl who came first is my sister. Who? Yes? The man who won the prize is my brother, the father. Okay? So, who? Yes? Then some pronouns are used to ask question. Like, what is your name? Which class are you in? Who is your coach? They are called interrogative pronouns. What are they called? Interrogative. Okay? Now, here in this, you can underline what type of pronouns are there and name their types. Now, since it's explained, I want you to do it for your self-study. Okay? And do it and write it in your notebook. Okay? We'll meet now next lecture.